oh man, all electronics are gone. Like all this shit's like gone, condensed, man. This is like my childhood, man. This is like where I first bought my very first Nintendo Entertainment System, the 8-bit Nintendo back in the day. Oh, damn. Look at this shit. They're installing the furniture and the shelvings and crap, like... Oh, damn. This is so messed up. So many stores, but not Toys R Us, man. Not fucking Toys R Us, man. Look at that. Fixtures for sale and everything. It's just sad. It's just really sad, man. And you know what? My whole life, I never even got one of those, I wish it was a Toys R Us kid shirt. I'm a Toys R Us kid. They probably stopped printing them who knows how long ago, but it just shocks me, man. I'll go see if there's anything worth getting, you know, but we'll see. And so today, June 30th, 2018, marks the first day of a world without Toys R Us. Just think about that for a moment. Any day, any kid that is born today, any newborn child born today, will exist in the world where Toys R Us only exists in the history books, and I guess Wikipedia is still around by the time the kid grows up. Yes, yesterday, Friday, which is June 29th of 2018, almost all, if not all, the Toys R Us businesses in the world shut their doors for the very last time. And I do say almost all because I'm kind of holding out hope because there is still an active Blockbuster somewhere in Alaska. There's got to be some small town somewhere that's still got Toys R Us. And if that place also happens to be Alaska, then maybe Alaska's a place to be, right? But what can I say? I think nowadays there just isn't too much demand for toys. Like, kids don't really play with toys anymore. They're all on their tablets, their iPhones, their electronics. They're all playing their games or whatever, or doing Snapchat, Instagram, social media, whatever. I don't know. I think kids care more about Twitter tweets than toys. And, like, I come from a generation where, like, people had their tricycles, their little baby bicycles before they move up to the big ones. They had their He-Man action figures, Ninja Turtle action figures. A movie just came out. Quick, buy all the merchandise related to that movie, you know. Girls had Barbies, guys had G.I. Joes and Transformers, we had Cabbage Patch Kids, we had Teddy Ruxpin, we had Tickle Me Elmo, that was like the hottest Christmas toy of the year. Everyone just had to have a Tickle Me Elmo. Like, I never really understood that. And the Furbies were big for some reason, and the Beanie Babies were big also for some reason. And, well, actually, Funko Pops are basically the Beanie Babies of today, but I love Funko Pops. Like, video games were big, like, all the video games, like, the big Christmas game to get your Genesis with Streets of Rage 2 and Sonic 2 at Toys R Us and all that stuff. And, yeah, it changed a lot. Like I say, kids don't play with toys anymore. They got their mobile devices and whatever. And, like, when you think about video games, you don't really think about Toys R Us. You think about GameStop, which, of course, that's also kind of on its way out. Or Best Buy or some other place. It's like, oh my god, the PlayStation 4 just came out. You're not thinking, I gotta go to Toys R Us. You're thinking more like, I gotta go to Best Buy or something. So it's kind of different, you know? But, yeah, it's just kind of weird. My personal memories, I believe the first time I went to Toys R Us, if not sooner, maybe I was there as a baby and I forgot, I don't know. But my first memory was when Johnny and I were little kids and our parents took us there on a dark, rainy night to buy our very first Nintendo 8-bit entertainment system. And of course back then, oh my god, Nintendo, it was our very first home console. So as kids, that just blew our mind, playing video games at home, still at the arcades, oh my god, you know. And yeah, it was cool. And I also remember when the Game Boy was new, we went there once to check out stuff, and there was, you know, now we had a Nintendo, let's buy some games, and we saw like this big Game Boy model that had like the games advertised. And I guess if you push the buttons and stuff, you can select, like, what games you want to see examples of. Like, not actually play them, but just see them. Like, Super Mario Land and Tetris. I think Gradius. I'm not sure. Whatever games came out when the Game Boy first had its release. And I remember when Super Mario Bros., the cartoon was coming out. They had little clips. If you push the buttons, you can see the clips because it was coming out that summer. Oh, my God, Super Mario Bros. 3 cartoon this summer, you know, that kind of shit. But, yeah. You know, back in the day, for most franchises, stuff like Toys R Us and McDonald's and Showbiz Pizza and all them were places that you would only go once in a great while. They're always very far. They're always expensive. It was like a big event. If your parents come home or you go home from school or something and your parents are like, we're not going to have dinner here. We're actually going to go out to KFC. Like, oh shit, yeah, KFC, you know. But nowadays, like, you just go McDonald's or KFC, whatever the hell you want. Like, weird, you know. So, yeah, Toys R Us was always like a big event, you know. But now you can just go whenever. And I used to work at a place that's near Toys R Us. I would go there a couple hours earlier to check it out before I could go to work. And yeah, I would check out the toys. I would check out, like, the new 52 was still new at the time. So I got, like, the Batgirl comics and the Batman comics, because he had comic books at Toys R Us for a while. So that was kind of cool. I remember buying Street Fighter 2, the animated movie, Toys R Us, videotape. Back then, anime was still kind of newish to us. That was before we discovered Dragon Ball. So to see Street Fighter with that awesome animation, just fighting and beating the crap out of each other, we're like, holy shit, this is fucking awesome, you know? And that was before we ever knew there was a chummy bathing scene, you know? And, what can I say? A funny story was that when we moved to Mexico for a good while, we were still kind of adjusting ourselves to what American things are and are not in Mexico. Because, yeah, you know, they got McDonald's and KFC, they got Walmarts over there. So, our town didn't have a Toys R Us, but it was kind of smallish, so we weren't too surprised. So, during the trip, we went to Mexico City, which Mexico City is, I believe, the third or so largest city in the world. So we grabbed a taxi cab driver, and it was like, take us to Toys R Us. And the guy didn't know where. And it's like, you know, and he's driving around. And even as a kid, I'm thinking, like, it's a taxi driver. It's supposed to know where to go. You know, you see in movies, the taxi drivers always know where to go. They always know all the shortcuts or whatever. And it's like, how can you not know where Toys R Us is? This big-ass toy store with a fucking giant giraffe. Like, how can you not know where it is? And, oh, God. The closest thing this guy could find was a store, a mom's and pop's little toy store that was called Toys R Us, like A-R-A-S, Toys R Us, and, you know, they had the little pirated knockoff junk there, so, yeah, and I'm not 100% sure, you guys can correct me if I'm wrong, but I do believe that Toys R Us has never, ever been in Mexico, which, of course, now is too late, but, wow, and, what else can I say? Nowadays, the most recent things I did in Toys R Us are, of course, the action figures and the Funko Pops, of course. Toys R Us had their exclusive Funko Pops with their poses and stuff. And action figures, of course, have a bigger selection. Like, we like to buy Ninja Turtle figures and WWF figures on rare occasions. I don't really collect the WWE ones, but, you know, there's always one that stands out. I saw a Razor Ramon one. I just have to have the Razor Ramon, you know? But when you go to Walmart or so, they got their little toy sections. Like, the Turtles are just the basics, just the Turtles and Shredder, and that's it. And if you wanted to see, like, all the other characters or the super new ones that just came out, like, you had to go to Toys R Us. And, of course, wrestling, the same thing. They had two or three of the basic wrestlers, all of John Cena's and whatever, but if you wanted, like, Nakamura and Asuka and stuff, you had to go to Toys R Us. They had all the newest stuff there. And what can I say? Just, it's going to be weird without Toys R Us, man. I was filming our little Christmas shopping every year in the Video Game Masters Holiday Special. And you guys could see that I filmed some of Toys R Us, of course, in its better days when I had zero idea that it was going to go away. And, I mean, I think the first year we did it, we had no idea. The second year, there were already rumors kind of floating around that they were going to close it down and stuff like that. But, wow, like, I don't know what we're going to do for Christmas shopping. I would always go to Toys R Us and stuff and the mall and everything. I know people do all their online shopping, but, I mean, you save yourself money in shipping if you just go buy it in person. And it doesn't beat going in person, because it's until you go to that store that you look around and you find stuff you didn't even know. You're going to the store, you're like, whoa, that's a cool shirt. Johnny's going to like that. Whoa, there's a Becky Lynch action figure. Paige is going to like that. Like, you just got to go there in person as opposed to just, like, online shopping. And yeah, so I was telling people at work, I was like, dude, like, what are you going to do for Christmas this year without Toys R Us? Like, what about the Christmas shopping? And they look at me, they're like, Mark, I mean, online shopping, dude. Where you been? But, I mean, I do admit I do online shopping, but I do it mostly for rare stuff or things like, I think, geek.com or stuff like that isn't too common. But, like, the basic stuff, I would just go to Toys R Us to get it, you know? And what can I say? It's going to be weird without Toys R Us. It's just very weird. I don't even know what they're going to do with that big empty store. I don't know what it'll turn into. I mean, they got to turn into something sooner or later, right? But, wow. A world without Toys R Us. And I think KB Toys is still around. We don't have a KB Toys in our area. But
I don't know, man. I think you only have to go if you still have kids that still like toys or whatever, or like, you know, collectors of figures, you know, for collection purposes. You might have to go to just Walmart and Target and Best Buy, you know, the little toy section. I mean, the Funko Pops are fucking everywhere nowadays. Hot Topic got Funko Pops. But, yeah. What can I say? I don't know. It just hits me. Like, I don't really buy that many toys anymore except for Funko Pops. And again, you can get at Hot Topic or someplace. So, I'm not really, like, I don't know if I'm really going to miss it or I'm just going to be so surprised that it's just gone. That it's just gone. It's just Toys R Us has been here for the longest time. It's almost like saying, like you're telling me that McDonald's is gone, that Taco Bell is gone, that Dunkin' Donuts is gone, you know? That Sears, which I guess Sears is going to be going away too. I think they are closing down Sears. Oh, God. But, damn, it's the only place that's closing down. We also lost, like, Borders. And of course, Blockbuster Video and FYEs are closing their stores here and there. There are still towns that have them open, but some places are just closing down. And I don't know. It's just weird, man. We're just heading into a brand new digital world. And this video wasn't really going to head in that direction, but I guess it kind of is. I guess everything's going to be like just online. Everything's going to be just digital. It's going to be like that Sandra Bullock movie, The Net, where you're just at home ordering stuff online all day while leaving the house. Everything could just literally be at home all day in your computer. And that kind of sucks because you do have to go out. You do need that human interaction. You know, you do got to go out there and see stuff. And again, like I say, you save money in shipping and handling. Come on. Like, I like pro wrestling tees. So if those are pro wrestling tees here, they got one in Chicago, by the way. But if there was a pro wrestling tees in our part of the world, I would have gone there. They had to drag me out there. It was so awesome if they had those shirts there in person. But, you know, that's the world that it is. And that's the direction we're heading. It's all going to be online. And all kids are going to grow up with electronics. And I mean, they're going to be younger and younger. You're going to see kids that are 5 years old that were, you know, on their tablets and iPads and crap. And when I was 5 years old, I mean, I was happy with a slingshot. I was happy with a skateboard or you know, something simple, not a fucking electronic device or whatever, you know. But that's where we live in. And what can I say, guys? Thanks for the memories of Toys R Us. The Facebook page actually says, stay tuned for more updates on our next adventure. And it says to be continued, you know, TRUB continued. So my only guess is that they have to open some kind of online shop, some kind of online store. Maybe they'll also work with Amazon or something. I don't know, but we'll see. We'll see what happens. Like I said, GameStop also is going down. And I know people like to make lots of comments and insult it. But for me, GameStop is where you go to buy video games, you know, an actual store that's all about video games. Not like Best Buy that has a video game section, but it's not a video game store. But again, that's where we're all headed. And what can I say? This is Art Rodriguez here. And, you know, Jeffrey the Giraffe, if you're listening somewhere, or the CEO of Toys R Us, if you're still alive or whatever, thank you for the memories. I'll always be a Toys R Us kid. And my regret is I never got to buy one of those I Want to Be a Toys R Us Kid shirts. Oh, well. See you next time, guys.